In some more news breaking this minute, and this regarding the allegations of sexual misconduct and assault against Jalandhar Bishop Franco Mullakal, the missionary of Jesus statement. Another statement coming in, and a relative of the nun has accused the nun for having an illicit relation with her husband. Bishop Father Mullakal has asked for the investigation in this matter, and that is the statement they're coming in, also saying that the missionaries of Jesus statement saying that the nun attempting to defame Father Mullakal. This is the statement coming in from the missionaries of Jesus, saying that the protesting nuns are blatant liars. Our executive editor Faye D'Souza joining us live with further updates on this. Faye, at a time when we are looking at support pouring in for the nun, there are protest after protest going on outside the Kerala High Court. This is a statement coming in by the missionaries of Jesus, calling those nuns blatant liars, and the victim also shaming the victim and saying that this has been a vendetta against the bishop.
Well, Apurva, this is obviously despicable behavior at this point, coming out of the PRO of this organization, Missionaries of Jesus. Now, what a lot of people might not know, and this has been signed by Sister Amala, who is the PRO of the Missionaries of Jesus, a fresh press release that came out. Now, what a lot of people don't know is that the Missionaries of Jesus is an order of nuns that's headed by the Bishop of Jalandhar, in this case, Bishop Franco. He is the boss of this order. So he effectively runs this order, and any press release coming out of the order is coming directly from him. So we should be very clear about the fact that these press releases are coming from the accused. Now, there are several things wrong with this situation. First of all, it has been months since his first accusation came out. This so-called bishop is free. He has not been arrested. He has not been taken in for questioning, which means the state is dragging its feet. We have more than enough evidence to know that the church has completely turned a blind eye. The Catholic Church of India and the Catholic Church from Rome downwards has completely turned a blind eye to this entire problem. We know that the victim in this particular case has written not just to the Archbishop of Delhi, to the Archbishop of various parts of the country, has written in fact also to what is the ambassador of the papacy in India, has written to Rome as well about the problem she was facing and received zero response, which means that the church at this point has actually shielded the rapist or the accused rapist here by their silence. The church has said absolutely nothing. They have not initiated any sort of internal investigation against this so-called bishop. Neither have they passed on this complaint to the police, which is what they should have done. Now we have weak responses coming from representatives of the Catholic Church saying that they want the law to take its course. Now, they can no longer say the law should take its course, because if that is what they really believed in, they should have brought in the police 3 months ago when they first received a complaint from this nun back in May. So obviously something is horribly wrong here. The church must completely realize that its silence is shielding the accused. And if they claim that they really believe in the word of the law, then they should have handed him over to the police months ago. But let's just go over this this press release that has come out now from the Missionaries of Jesus. PRO Sister Amla, who has issued this press release, she says basically that Bishop Franco Mullakal ordered an inquiry committee against the nun who is now accusing him of rape. That apparently, according to this press release, this despicable press release, the nun had an affair with a taxi driver and a problem with that taxi driver's wife, who found out about it, which is why the bishop ordered an inquiry. And this entire allegation now is blatant lies and being made to take revenge against him. Now, consider the fact that despite this
also, accusation... Also, help us understand one thing, the fact...
Yes, go ahead.
Right. Also, if you help us understand one thing, we just heard that the Cardinal Oswald Gracias, who's the president of the Catholic Bishops Conference of India, he had come out with a statement saying that he is also going to take this step further, and said that they are recommending that this bishop should step down. So there's a very stern statement coming in from the Cardinal. In the light of that statement, what does this statement of the Missionaries of Jesus mean?
So see, you, like I said at the beginning, we must remember that this statement of the Missionaries of Jesus is coming from the accused. He is the head of the Missionaries of Jesus. So he's actually sitting there writing out these press releases and getting somebody to sign them. The problem here is this, what you're calling a stern message from the Cardinal is not a stern message. What do you mean you want him to step down? He should have been removed unceremoniously 3 months ago. He should have been handed over to the police 3 months ago. You are allowing him control and power over the victims of this case. You're allowing him control and power over the entire order. He's still over the house. He's still putting out press releases in their names. So the fact that this man is still being allowed to be in a position of power within the Catholic Church shows that these statements that are now being made by the Cardinal are lip service. They're too little, too late. They should have come months ago, and that the Church is not really serious. Now, even if the Cardinal is now put out a release saying that he will raise this matter with the Pope in Rome, it is too late. You are doing it now because it is such a mess in the media. You are doing it now because of all the bad press the Church is doing, the getting. If this problem had gone away, or you managed to make it go away, you would have never raised it. If you were serious, you should have raised it 3 months ago. So obviously, the Catholic Church here coming off looking very, very weak, very, very low on discipline, zero internal accountability, and zero respect for the law as well.
Absolutely, and this is a rather shocking statement there coming in. As you said, it is a despicable statement coming in from the Missionaries of Jesus. We leave it there, Faye. Many thanks for joining us and giving us a perspective of this entire case and what are these multiple statements that is coming out from various church bodies really mean in this regard.